In space, in an area not known well, beyond the Kuiper Belt, is where I dwell. In the Oort Cloud, a spherical shell that surrounds our solar system like an ice-filled bubble. I'm Sedna, a Dwarf Planet Candidate hoping for a promotion, named after the Inuit Goddess of the November 2003, Chandra Hio, David Rabinowitz, and Mike Brown were watching the skies from the Palomar Observatory, and that's when I was found. At the time, I was the furthest object discovered far away where it's cold and icy. So I was named after the Inuit Goddess of the Sea. Legend says she lives in the coldest, darkest depths of the sea, where there is not light or heat, but plenty of space to roam free. Just like her, I'm drifting along in the cold, dark depths of space. Living in the chilling shadows is something I've come to embrace. I'm Sedna, a Dwarf Planet Candidate, hoping for a promotion, named after the Inuit Goddess of the Ocean. 84 billion miles from the sun, I travel on my own. I have no moons to keep me company, I'm all alone. I take over 11,000 years to orbit once around our sun. I can't even remember my last birthday celebration. My rotational period is fairly short, though. Approximately 10 hours for one Sedna day, you know. I'm so far away from the sun that if you were on the surface of me, an extremely bright star in the sky is all that you would see. I'm Sedna, a Dwarf Planet Candidate, hoping for a promotion, named after the Inuit Goddess of the Ocean. Even at perihelion, the closest I'll get to the sun, I'll still be beyond the Kuiper Cliff when my orbit is done. In 2076, I'll be closest to the sun. 76 AUs is my perihelion. But I will get as far as 937 AUs when at aphelion. Other objects beyond the Kuiper Cliff with elliptical orbits like me include the goblin Orlelea Kuhonua and VP-113. We are known as Sednoids, which was named after me. Trans-Neptunian objects whose perihelion is still beyond the Kuiper Cliff, you see. I'm Sedna, a Dwarf Planet Candidate, hoping for a promotion, named after the Inuit Goddess of the Ocean. One of the reddest objects found in the solar system so far, similar to the bright reddish color found on the planet Mars. My surface is covered in frozen nitrogen and methane, but astronomers also discovered water ice in my domain. It is extremely cold on me. Temperatures as low as negative 410 degrees. You will need to dress really warm to visit, or you will freeze. I'm Sedna, a Dwarf Planet Candidate, hoping for a promotion, named after the Inuit Goddess of the Ocean. Chances of astronomers finding me were very low, you see. But sometimes when you are gazing at the stars, you can get lucky. No one can take my picture because very little sunlight reaches me. It's so dark that I'm hidden in shadow and still quite a mystery. It'll probably be a very long time until your scientists will learn more of my history. But maybe in the distant future, you'll be able to visit me. I'm Sedna, a Dwarf Planet Candidate, hoping for a promotion, named after the Inuit Goddess of the Ocean.
We hope you enjoyed this episode of Meet the Dwarf Planet. Stay tuned for our next episode, Dwarf Planet Candidate, Quayor. We'll see you soon. Thanks for watching. Bye.